Hey guys, welcome back to Transgender Talk Time with Ashley. I'm a 38-year-old transgender woman. This is my online journal where I talk to you guys about my transition as well as things that I deal with through my day-to-day. So if you would, let's go ahead and pull up a chair. We're gonna talk for a bit. Well, I had a pretty good day. As you know, not every day is a good day. And some days we wanna celebrate. Some days we wanna let off steam. For me, in the past, that always involved alcohol. Today we're returning to the addiction series, and I'm going to talk about my struggle with alcoholism, how it affected my life, and some of the things that it cost me. Sticking with the format that I've been using through the addiction series, I have started out by giving the definition of the different addictions. Alcoholism. The definition is an addiction to the consumption of alcoholic liquor or the mental illness and compulsive behavior resulting from alcohol dependency. This is a disease that drives you to continue to drink even when you don't want to anymore. Nowadays, alcohol dependency is kind of considered a little bit of a taboo, and a lot of people don't like to talk about it. I grew up through the mid to late 80s. The lifestyle here in the US was quite centered around alcohol consumption during those times. I remember quite a bit going to different cookouts, going to bars, going to the VFW, even just a Tuesday evening at the house. It was the 80s. I remember being told these stories of being 2 years old and being able to pour a beer out of a keg. Alcoholism is something that I have been around pretty much my whole life. I want to talk about how alcoholism manifested in my own personal life. Like I mentioned a few moments ago, I remember drinking beer super, super young. I remember growing up, my stepdad would ask me to go get a beer. And I was allowed to open the beer and have a sip off of it every time that I walked it over to him. So I definitely acquired a taste and a liking for beer at a very young age. Through high school, I remember many a times going to parties. I remember buying a bunch of alcohol for my senior prom. I remember being 18, 19 years old, partying on Halloween night. I drank to celebrate, I drank to repress. When my daughter was born, I didn't drink as much for a bit. Her mother and I occasionally would have a drink, but it was a drink. Her and I had split up at one point. I was drinking really hard. She had reached out to me, letting me know that her daughter needed a doctor's appointment, potentially gonna need a surgery, which luckily was averted. We had been split up. We had started talking about getting back together. This was probably the first time that I truly recognized that I was an alcoholic. I remember saying, hey, you know, I have a problem with alcohol that I'm gonna need help with. She wasn't very accepting. She was very, very angry. I went into straight denial and ignored it. Tried to cope and hide it. I got in an accident, almost cost me my life. It was horrific. Luckily, I was the only person that was injured in it. I've made 90% recovery. There's some stuff that's never gonna heal. I just have to deal with that consequence. I continued to drink. I married another lady. She never really vocalized any frustration towards my drinking in the beginning. That's when my addiction really started to get out of control. Alcohol caused a lot of bad in my life. I can't really think of anything good that it brought. Things that it caused for me, the obvious, being hard on our liver, being hard on your stomach, weight gain. I've been told that it causes brain damage over time. It caused me a lot of anger. I remember when I would drink heavily, it was so very easy to blow up, be a mean drunk. It got to the point I didn't even like drinking. Several times I got to that point. It caused me to lose a friendship with the mother of my children, which is one of the biggest regrets that I've ever had. I'm not going to buy into that people shouldn't have regrets. It's completely acceptable to have regrets. It caused me bad judgment. It caused me a lot of financial loss. And that's the least of my worries. It caused me my second marriage completely. It made me a complete asshole. I was so oblivious to everything. I thought everything was everyone else's fault. I definitely accept responsibility for the vast majority of all of these circumstances. It caused me relationships with the two absolute most important people on this planet to me. That's with my kids. I'm extremely lucky that I have had the chance to be a part of my daughter's life again. I wish I could go back and change those things because I missed 4.5 or 5 years. So November of her 8th grade year was the last time that I really got to see her until earlier this year. It's been the same time since I've seen my son. I don't know if I'll ever be able to forgive myself. I was in a very, very dark spot because of my alcohol. Their mom, stepdad, spoke with me over the phone about their mental state. We did a lot of talking. I made the worst bullshit cop-out decision I've ever made in my life. I decided to walk away because between the three of us, we all kind of agreed that I wasn't in a position to be a healthy partner in their life. That just kills me. And I walked away. And it breaks my heart. Alcohol has cost me everything. So in the previous video about my food addiction, we talked about whether or not anxiety and depression feed into these addictions. Well, just like with food, alcohol for me was the same way. I can't tell you how many times, being upset, I'd turn to the bottle to try and make it go numb. Wake up the next day and realize, well, I'm still doing the same things that's keeping me from the things that are important. I'd get sad and depressed, or I'd get anxious, and it definitely fed into this vicious cycle, destroyed everything. Alcohol definitely was very bad in my life. There is an end to this cycle. The road to recovery started officially 4 years ago. I was living in Asheville at the time, going through a divorce, living with my best friend, Kenneth. Each weekend when we would come home from driving truck, I was just drinking like a fish. Got to the point that I realized I was stagnating. Long story short, I come home one weekend and looked at Kenneth and was like, hey, I'm gonna go to the scuba shop. This is something that he and I had talked about for 2 years. So I started scuba diving. We started scuba diving. Scuba diving and alcohol don't go hand in hand. Dehydration is the number one predisposition for DCS, or decompression sickness. I tried to make it a point not to drink the night before I would go diving when I would come home, but that still left me time to drink other times. I was drinking a lot still. 15 months after I got certified, I'd done an instructor's course. About 3 months later, I decided I was going to leave Asheville to teach scuba full time. I continued drinking, which led to other bad situations down here. I got to the point where it wasn't good. It was causing so many arguments, so many fights, and so many lost friends. I really cut my drinking back this time of year, last year, maybe just a little bit earlier than this. While still being an active alcoholic, I got down to where I was having one drink, if any, towards the end. So if I even had just one of those drinks, it was causing me the next day to have reverse sinus blocks. With scuba being the thing that saved my life initially, I knew that if I kept drinking, I wouldn't be able to dive. And so as soon as it started causing this issue, I was able to cut it out completely. I don't think about drinking to celebrate anymore. I don't think about drinking to numb the pain. At the time that this video is released, I will have been sober for 5 months and 6 days. So 5 months and 6 days celebrated on August 17th. And I'm really proud of that. So it's been a really dark and heavy topic this week. I know I've mentioned in the past that I try to always look for the silver lining in things. The silver lining would be that because I have lost everything and been beyond rock bottom, I know how to actually appreciate the things in life. I know that no matter what, I will never, ever make those mistakes again. I will not take another drink. I know that if I'm ever lucky enough to be a part of the life for the people that I hurt because of my alcoholism, I will never let them down or hurt them. I definitely finally learned my lesson. We're back to that segment that everybody seems to like called What's Good. I just had two really good friends come into town. They stayed with me, David and Christina. Had an absolute blast, got to dive with them, you know, break bread with them. It was a lot of fun. I know you guys are probably watching, so I'll see you in New York at some point, I promise you that. Even with my struggles with alcohol, I've been able to reconnect and talk with my daughter. I'm so very lucky to have her, to feel like I'm part of her life again. I'm one lucky person. So that's about all the time that I had this evening for talking about the alcohol addiction that I've dealt with. If you like the video, go ahead and hit the like button. If you want to get weekly updates to my videos, go ahead and subscribe. I release videos weekly on Wednesday morning at 8 a.m. Eastern Time in the United States. Comment down below and let me know if you are dealing with an alcohol addiction. Let me know how you're coping with it. Like always, if you want to share these videos, please feel free to. I put these on here also as an attempt to help other people with their progress, their transition, even trying to help with people overcoming their own personal addictions as well. Don't forget, you can follow me on all the different social media platforms. You can find me on Facebook. You can also find me on Instagram. And I do have a Snapchat as well. Just a sneak peek about next week's video, I'm going to be talking about being out publicly as a transgender female for a year now. I want to say thank you to everyone for hanging out and helping me get through this video this week. It was a really hard one for me to do, and I appreciate your patience. I look forward to seeing you all next week. And until then, everybody, have a good time. Be safe out there. I love you all. Cheers. If I close my eyes forever.